Good afternoon and welcome to the Epiphany of Our Lord Catholic Church. Today is the second Sunday of Easter. Please stand and join in singing our opening hymn, number 524, Alleluia, number 1.
Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name. Jesus is Lord of all the earth. He is the King of creation. Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name. Spread the good news o'er all the earth. Jesus has died and has risen. Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name. We have been crucified with Christ. Now we shall live forever. Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name.
Good afternoon. Bless your heart and grace your good soul. We are in the octave of Easter, and this is the Divine Mercy Sunday. Did you realize that we had Easter, and then we have First Friday, Feast of the Sacred Heart, and First Saturday, Feast of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, and now we come to Divine Mercy Sunday. We have four graces, four blessings in 1 week. Aren't you overwhelmed by grace and blessings and excitement and jubilation? You're ready to flap your arms and be like an eagle and soar with the angels. This is a beautiful week. Yeah. And then on Friday, I was driving from Latrobe, where it was raining, to Torrance Hospital up in Blairsville, and I ran into snow. Did you get snow here? Yeah. So, you know, these are the time of season when Father Time and Mother Nature, they kind of like argue, and we have to suffer because of that. So, good sufferings. We open our hearts, we lift up our voice, we praise and glorify the eternal God. We ask the Father, in the name of Jesus, to breathe the breath of the Holy Spirit upon us and within us, and with the fire of the Holy Spirit, warm our hearts so that we may have everlasting joy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, bring us all to everlasting life.
Glory. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Thank you.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was one of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The second reading is from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome. For whoever is begotten by God conquers the world, and the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to St. John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them. Whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord. But he said to them, unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe. Now, a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, peace be with you. Then he said to Thomas, put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe. Thomas answered and said to him, my Lord and my God. And Jesus said to him, have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief, you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. When I was with you for Easter Sunday, I mentioned that I tried to watch the film Jesus of Nazareth, directed by Franco Zeffirelli. What I did not tell you at that time was that there was a religious experience in the filming of that movie. Some of you may know of Ernest Borgnine. He was the Roman soldier in the movie. In 1977, after the filming of Jesus of Nazareth by Franco Zeffirelli, Ernest Borgnine gave an interview. And he told the interviewer that, on the movie set, when it came time for the crucifixion, and I was standing under the cross, and I looked up into Robert Powell, and Robert Powell said, Father, forgive them. Ernest Borgnine said, in my mind's eye, I saw the face of Jesus, and spontaneously, my eyes welled up with tears, and large tears flowed down my cheeks. And I turned and looked over at Anne Bancroft, who was playing Mary Magdalene, and she was weeping and sobbing. And I looked at the other actors and actresses, and they spontaneously were in tears. You cannot watch the movie, Jesus of Nazareth. You cannot look at the crucified Lord and hear him say, Father, forgive them. They don't know what they're doing. The other part of that would be, Father, if they knew me as you know me, they would not do this. And so Jesus not only died for us, he made excuses for us. What kind of love is there that would do such a thing? Not only die, but make excuses. You know, my friends, when you read the sacred scriptures and the crucified Jesus, you come to that part where he hanged his head and died. But Jews and Romans wanted more proof. And so they ordered one of the soldiers with a lance to pierce his heart. And out came blood and water. I call your attention to the portrait in front of the altar. On this Divine Mercy Sunday, I brought a portrait of Jesus as he asked to be painted, and I placed it before you at this altar. In the 19th century, actually 17th century, excuse me, in the 17th century, in 1673, our blessed Lord Jesus appeared to a woman in a convent. We now know her as Saint Margaret Mary. And he said to Saint Margaret Mary, "My heart is bursting with love for my people. I can no longer hold back this love. And so I decided now is the time for a devotion to my Sacred Heart to be instituted on earth. And I have decided to make you my disciple and call you the Apostle of the Sacred Heart." And he gave her prayers to be prayed, a medal to be stamped, and pictures to be drawn. Unfortunately, there were those in her convent, as well as in general society, that did not believe her. They were very skeptical. If that was not enough, he also said, "I want institution of the First Fridays. Everyone who goes to confession, attends Mass for First Friday, prays for the intention of the Holy Father, I will grant them total remission of sin." Unbelievable how God is going out of his way to be assured that we will be with him for eternity. In the 20th century, in 1905, a baby girl, one of 10 children, was born to peasants. At the age of 7, she said she wanted to become a nun, and her father forbid her. When she was 18, her sister took her to a dance. And while she was at that dance, Jesus came to her and said, "How much longer must I put up with you? When are you going to come and follow me as I've asked you?" At the age of 18, wearing nothing but the dress she had on, not going back home to get any supplies, she got on a train and went to Warsaw and join a convent. But they would not take her in because she did not have the money to pay for the material to have the habit made. So she worked as a housemaid for over a year. And when she got paid, she went to that convent, gave the money to Mother Superior so that materials could be bought for the habit to be sewn that she would wear when she entered the convent. We know this young girl as Saint Faustina. And Jesus appeared to her and said, "My heart is overwhelming with love, and I want my heart to be loved throughout the whole world." And so he showed himself to her, as you see in this portrait. And he said, "I want you to have a portrait painted of me as you see me." And he stood in a white garment with his hand pointing to his chest. and the other hand lift up to heaven. And out of that heart came rays, white rays and red rays, representing blood and water, representing the two sacraments, baptism that takes away original sin, and blood in the Eucharist that feeds us and sustains us in faith. And so Saint Faustina went to her superior, who did not believe her, and the sisters did not believe her, and Rome did not believe her, and for 20 years they banned her book that she wrote, her journal, The Journey of Divine Mercy. You know who got it released? A young seminarian who became a bishop, who took the name John Paul II. He and the other Polish bishops convinced Rome to release the ban so that this material could be out in the world as Jesus instructed. The reason he banned her writings was because it was translated into Italian and German and French, and the good souls in the Vatican responsible for our doctrine of Catholic faith, they read the Italian translation that was very poorly translated. And so the bishops, the Polish bishops, and the two cardinals said, "Holy Father, please read this in Polish. I don't speak Polish. Read it in Polish. Have someone read it in the original as it was written." And when they did, their eyes were opened, their ears were opened, their hearts were opened, and her writings were propagated throughout the world. And today we are here on this Feast of Divine Mercy. But there was a bishop who became the Holy Father and is now St. John Paul II, who led the movement to have her writings approved. Jesus told Faustina that when you pray, pray the Chaplet of Divine Mercy, because when you die, you will come to me and there will be two doors you will have to pass through. The first door is called the Door of Mercy. And if you don't pass through the Door of Mercy by praying Divine Mercy, then you will have to walk through the door of divine justice. You don't want to stand before the door of divine justice. I hope and pray that we come to realize that in the gospel, Mary Magdalene went and told the apostles that Jesus appeared to her. Did they believe her? No. And so Jesus then came when all the apostles were together, sitting around the table, doing the Eucharist. But Thomas wasn't there. And when Thomas came to them and they told him, did Thomas believe? Nah, he didn't believe. Do you know that St. Padre Pio was not believed for 2 years? The Vatican silenced him for 2 years because of misinformation, gossip, and rumor led to him being silenced. He could not hear confessions. He could not do public mass. He could not speak with people. He had to be silent. And he was silent. And the Lord Jesus told him and others, you are obedient. And obedience is the virtue that unlocks the silence. I hope and pray we come to realize that we are given this opportunity of divine mercy, to pray the Chaplet of Divine Mercy. There's so much more you can learn by going to the website. Jesus made 17 promises for those who pray the Chaplet of Divine Mercy. And he said, 3 times I come to the dying, and each time I offer them salvation, they accept it or reject it. And anyone who is dying, who is praying the Chaplet of Divine Mercy, or anyone who is kneeling at the bed of a dying, praying the Chaplet of Divine Mercy, when that immortal soul stands before my Heavenly Father, he will see not your soul, he sees me. And when he sees me, he doesn't deny me anything. And so, my friends, on the Feast of Divine Mercy, I would encourage you, read your scriptures, celebrate your sacraments, take 20 minutes a day reading the Divine Mercy journey, pray in the chaplet of divine mercy. Continue to pray and fast. God has unleashed upon this earth so many graces if we will only come and ask for them. There's much more I could tell you, but time's running out for me. And Blessed Mother in 1917 at Fatima asked for something, and she said, if the bishops in union with Holy Father will consecrate Russia to me, you will have peace. And the bishops did not do it. And so we have not had peace. And Jesus said to Faustina, the humanity on earth will never know peace until they humble themselves before me. For our profession of faith, we will renew our baptismal promises during this Easter octave on this the Feast of Divine Mercy. My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance has been concluded, we are renewing our baptismal promises by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so, my friends, I ask you, do you reject Satan and all of his works and all of his empty show? Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you? Do you renounce Satan, the author and the prince of sin? Amen. Do you believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth? Amen. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, is seated at the right hand of the Father? Amen. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Amen.
Give me the holy water over there. And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us in his grace, in Christ Jesus our Lord, for eternal life. And they all said,
Amen.
Okay, I walk among you, sprinkle you with this holy water, reminding you of your baptism and the renewal of your promises.
Thank you.
Throughout the history of the church, God has always sent his beloved Son and our Blessed Mother to us. They always come with messages of redemption and salvation. They always come with opportunities to receive blessings and graces. And so we take this opportunity to ask the Heavenly Father to hear our prayers and grant these petitions. Prayers of the faithful.
Our response will be, Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that we may be bearers of God's mercy to all who need it most, especially those who find themselves doubting God's presence in their lives or in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to armed conflict and to gun violence, so that all God's children may enjoy the peace that Jesus offers, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle to believe in a merciful God in the face of evil and sin in the world, that Jesus' promise of his redemptive presence in a broken world may strengthen their faith and give them hope, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all newly initiated Christians, that their faith may be strengthened in community, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may emulate the early Christian community as described in today's first reading, sharing that we have so that no person goes needy, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died may be part of the risen Lord's promise of peace. And during this liturgy, we remember Larry Morrow. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, eternal Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, throughout time you sent us patriarchs and prophets, judges and kings, but in these end times you sent your beloved Son, Jesus, who called the apostles and sent them with disciples to proclaim your gospel, to forgive sin, to celebrate Eucharist, and to proclaim the gospel throughout the world. Filled with your Holy Spirit, we gather together because of their witness. Now make us witnesses unto you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our preparation hymn is number 680, We Walk by Faith.
We walk by faith and not by sight. No gracious words we hear from him who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him near. We may not touch his hands and side, nor follow where he trod, but in his promise we rejoice and cry, my Lord and God. Help then, O Lord, our unbelief, and may our faith seek where you are found. That when our life of faith is done, in realms of clearer light, we may behold you as you are, walk by faith and not by sight. No gracious words we hear from him who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him near. We may not touch his hands and side, nor follow where he trod, but in his promise we rejoice and cry, my Lord and God.
Lord, in praise in heavens, on the earth forevermore.
Help then, O Lord, our unbelief, and may our faith abound to call on you when you are near and seek where you are found. That when our life of faith is done, in realms of clearer light,
your goodness we have received,
we may behold you as you are,
will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. Come for us our spiritual drink. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me of all my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new birth through baptism and renewed by confession of your name. They may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising the life of all who have risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes
comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these holy offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Larry, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, where they offered for themselves and for all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and our Lord Jesus Christ, with Saint Joseph, her spouse. We pray also for Peter and Paul, the apostles and the martyrs, John, James, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysologus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service and that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, the Almighty Father, giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Proclaim your death, O Lord, until Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Savior, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to you your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty Father, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through the participation of this altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in a sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all good things for us. You sanctify them, fill them with life, you bless them and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we have the courage to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of Christ Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us take this opportunity to share some sign of the Lord's peace with each other.
Jesus, Lamb.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Our communion hymn is number 945, I Am the Bread of Life.
Blood of Christ. Blood of Christ. Blood of Christ.
Truly it is.
I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and to believe in me shall
body of Christ.
And I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up on the last day. Unless you eat of the flesh of the Son of Man and drink blood and drink of his blood, you shall not have life within you, and I will raise you up, and I
has come into the world, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bow your head, pray for God's blessing, and after each prayer respond, Amen. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his beloved Son endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast, come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, our Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you, be with you now and always.
Amen.
In the works of a mystic that I'm studying, Jesus tells her that Satan is more afraid of you than you are of him. He fears you because his only weapons against you are sin, washed away by the waters of baptism, and death given to you through the resurrection of Jesus. He has nothing against you. You have a lot against him. Don't ever doubt your Catholic faith. Go in peace, the Mass is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Our closing hymn is number 540, Jesus Christ is Risen Today.
Thank you. Christ is risen today.
Hymns of praise, then let us